Hi friends, welcome to the new series JavaScript Hero to Superhero. In this series, I'm talking about some advanced concepts in JavaScript. If you are a beginner trying to learn JavaScript, there is another series, JavaScript 0 to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. In this video, I'm going to talk about call, apply, and bind in JavaScript. In the last video, I have talked about this keyword. The this keyword in JavaScript behaves differently compared to other programming languages. In other object-oriented programming languages, the this keyword always refers to the current instance of the class. Whereas in JavaScript, the value of this depends on how your function is called. And we can use call, bind, and apply methods to set the this keyword independent of how the function is called. In other words, it helps us to replace the value of this inside a function with whatever value we want. Let me explain these three using some examples. First, let us see about call. The call method sets the this inside the function and immediately executes that function. Let me explain. Let me create an object in which let me have a first name, a last name, and a function to prepare the full name from this first and last names. So if I call object1.fullname, we can see the full name is getting printed. Assume I have another object in which I have another first name and last name. Now I cannot use the full name function in the object 1 directly to print the object 2 because here this is pointing to this object 1. But we can use call method here to change the context. So let me use object1.fullname.call of object 2. If I execute now, we can see this. But instead of keeping this function inside object 1, we can keep it outside. That means in global object. And we can use call function to pass the respective object. So we can see this. Here you can note this is pointing to the respective object. To explain it clearly, let me execute this in a browser. Let me create a test function and inside that, let me print this. And let me create an object in which I just have a name. Now if I call the function directly, we can see here this is pointing to window object. But if I use call method, we can see here this is pointing to this object instead of window object. Apart from this, call method also accepts multiple parameters so that we can use that in our function like this. Hope you understood about call method. Now let's see about apply method. The apply method is similar to call. The only difference is that the apply method accepts an array of arguments instead of comma separated values. Let me use the same example. So here, if I use apply instead of call, I need to pass these arguments as an array instead of comma separated values. Now, if I execute, we get the same result. Hope you understood about apply method. Now let's see about bind method. We have seen the call method sets the this inside the function and immediately executes that function. But instead, the bind method creates a new function and sets the this keyword to the specified object. To explain this, let me take the same example what I used for explaining call method. So here, if I change the call to bind, it won't work. Because like call, it won't execute immediately. Instead, it returns a function. So let me use another variable to get the function and then let me execute this. Now we can see it is giving us the same result. Also, instead of doing in this way, we can just bind the object, get the function, and then we can pass the arguments later like this. This will also work. Hope you understood the use of call, bind, and apply and their differences. I believe you like this video. Please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.